Jenny, great to see you.
Thank you.
Thank you so much for joining us. Let's start first, Jenny, with corporate culture. So how would you describe the corporate culture at Franklin Resources?
We have what we call four core values, and they're putting clients first, building relationships with our partners, measuring what we do to ensure quality results, and working with integrity. When you walk around our firm, there's just a passion that people feel around what we do, because we think we help people solve for some of the most important concerns in their life.
Do you think a corporate culture has to evolve with the times?
We have offices in 35 countries and clients in 170 countries, right? I mean, people could work 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, because somewhere in the world there's somebody going on.
Yeah, there's something going
on. And technology, unfortunately, makes you kind of plugged into that. And so I think in the old days where people went to work and then you went home, we're two different things, and now it looks much more like that. And so you have to recognize that as a company and start to evolve your management practices around the changes.
On a regular basis, who do you surround yourself with in business?
Anybody I talk to, I'm curious about how their business runs, because you can pick something up on one industry that you think, wow, I could use it over here. So I like surrounding myself with smart, motivated, passionate people.
Have you surrounded yourself with someone who's taught you something important in life?
My greatest mentor from a business standpoint is my father, who really was the one that grew Franklin Templeton. He always said, take care of the client and the stock price takes care of itself.
What do you do when you hit a wall?
The higher up you go in an organization, the harder the problems get, right? People no longer bring the easy problems to you, you only get the tough problems. Hitting a wall is about first making sure that you really need to be on the other side of that wall, and then two, just continuing to solve a problem or a difficult situation and hopefully turn it into really an opportunity.
How do you overcome indecision?
So I'm probably not a person that people would say is indecisive, but I do have kind of a philosophy that is, don't make a decision you don't have to. And that doesn't mean don't make a decision, because not making a decision is a decision. More often than not, you have to make pretty quick decisions, and you have to make them with partial information and not being afraid to make a decision.
What about data? How much does data play into your decision-making process?
I mean, I'm a big fan of data. I mean, it is the way I think everybody has operated. Every CEO, every executive has always operated with trying to get information and data. The difference today is there's just so many more sources in which you can get data. Being open and trying to think about creative ways to add to your traditional methods of getting information is really important for any executive.
How do you balance work and life?
So I have great supportive kids. They've always known me as a working mom, and it's really important to make sure that you create time for the big things, both in personal life and in work. Firms that are willing to be more flexible for employees, they'll have the greater talent. People appreciate that.
What is the best advice you could give a woman starting out in her career right now?
Read your annual report once, because then you'll know what's on the CEO's mind, and understand how you fit into that. You have to take some risks, and then you have to be resilient. If you take risks, you're going to fail sometimes, and just recognize that that's actually a great opportunity to learn.
What's the best advice you've ever gotten?
Failing is just a step along the way. You just have to get back up and be persistent and keep at it. And it is the person who is the most persistent that will be successful.
Who inspires you? Which businesswoman inspires you, and why?
Indra Nooyi of Pepsi. And the reason why, you know, she had the vision of recognizing that healthy snacks were going to be important. She so fundamentally believed that that was the right direction, and the world has changed to looking for much more healthy types of foods and snacks. And so I just admire that.
Jenny, thank you so much.
Absolutely.
That was fantastic.
My pleasure.